ಶ್ರೀಮಾನ್ ವೆಂಕಟನಾಥಾರ್ಯ ಕವಿತಾರ್ಕಿಕ ಕೇಶರಿ ವೇದಾಂತಾಚಾರ್ಯವರ್ಯೋ ಮೇ ಸನ್ನಿಧತ್ತಾಂ ಸದಾ ಹೃತಿ. ಟುಡೇಸ್ ವರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವರ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ 11 ಆಫ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಆಳವಂದಾರ್ ಸ್ತೋತ್ರ ರತ್ನಂ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ವರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಸ್ ದ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ ಸುಪ್ರಿಮಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರೀಮನ್ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾರಿಫೈಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಅವರ್ ಈವನ್ ಅನ್ ಅಯೋಟ ಆಫ್ ಡೌಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಪರತ್ವಂ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರೀಮನ್ ನಾರಾಯಣ. ಸ್ವಾಭಾವಿಕಾನವಧಿಗಾಧಿಶಯೇಷಿತೃತ್ವಂ ನಾರಾಯಣತ್ವೈನ ಮೃಷ್ಯತಿ ವೈದಿಕ ಕಃ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಶಿವಶತಮಕ ಪರಮಸ್ವರಾಡಿತ್ ಏತೇಪಿ ಯಸ್ಯ ಮಹಿಮಾರ್ನವ ವಿಪ್ರುಷಸ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಸೇಸ್, ನಾರಾಯಣ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಶಿವ ಶತಮಕ ಪರಮಸ್ವರಾಟ್. ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಚತುರ್ಮುಖ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ, ಶಿವನ್ ಶತಮಕ ಇಂದಿರನ್, ಪರಮಸ್ವರಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಬೌವ್ ದೆಮ್. ಒತ್ತಾರ್ ಮಿಕ್ಕಾರ್ ಇಲಯಾಯ ಮಾಮಾಯ ಯು ಆರ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಒನ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಯು, ಯು ಆರ್ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್ ಟು ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಸಂಕಲ್ಪಂ. ಐ ಸೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಸ್, ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ಯು. ದರ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪಂ ದ ನೇಚರ್, ಸ್ಥಿತಿ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್, ದ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರವೃತ್ತಿ, the action, the deeds are all dependent on you. Swadhina trivita chetana achetana swarupa sthiti pravritti is all his adhinam, his control. Why can't they be of Brahma, Rudra et al? Even if they are all dependent on him, why can't he be dependent on someone above him who has delegated to him? The one above him would have granted him then power to rule the world. There could be such questions. Alavandar responds here in this verse that a Vaidiga, one who follows Vedas, Vedantam, Upanishad, would not ask such queries, such question, whether anybody is there. Why can't there be someone beyond Brahma, Rudra, Narayana, etc., others? So let us also learn from these Vaidikas. So which means the one who does not accept the supremacy of Sriman Narayana as declared in Vedas and Upanishads is not a Vaidika, does not believe in Vedas or does not understand the Vedas correctly. That's the meaning of this. So it appears when Ramanuja had heard this verse uttered by Trikachinambi, he was so mesmerized by this wonderful loaded verse, he went and asked him as to who had composed this and came to know that it was Swami Ramanacharya. Swabhavikanavadigadishayeshitrutvam narayanatvaina mrishyati vaidikah kaha brahmashivasatamaka paramaswaratityatepi yasya mahimarnava viprushaste. Narayana, Brahma, Shiva, Indra, Paramaswarat, Nitya Suris and all others, they are all none other than the minutest droplets of the vast, huge, unbounded ocean of your glorious Kalyana Gunas, attributes. You are in such greatest you, the unparalleled supreme one, you, you are the one. And swabhavika shabdam, it is karmobadhikamai, attale anityamai, dukkha mishramana brahmadigal aishwaryate vyavartikirade. This talks about sabram, and here even the our panchasuktam said sabrahma sasi vasrendra shokchara paramaswarate. So he is the one who is above all, Vattarmikar Ilayaya Bhamayan, you, the unparalleled supreme one, you, there is a rulership of all worlds and all beings, including the one listed above, which is Shivan, Chaturmukha Brahma, Devendra, and Paramaswarat, the Nitya Suris, by your very nature, due to your being our Lord in most wonderful manner, you rule us, and you are the Lord without any reason or excuse, Vyajyam, and such Ishwaratvam, being our Lord for all and everyone, which Vaidiga, who has studied Vedas, would not accept this. Everyone would, if he has really understood the Vedas and Shastras correctly. O Narayana, Brahma, Siva, Indra, Nityasuri, Muktas, and everyone else is all none but droplets of your ocean of your glories only. Who is the Vaidiga, the follower of Vedas and Shastras, one who has studied or understood the Vedas, who would not accept or acknowledge your supremacy or your Bhagavatvam, your Godhood, with such unparalleled, unsurpassed excellence? Vedas have mentioned Paratvam, the supremacy of Sriman Narayana, with many other names uttered in many places in Shrutis. It is true that Upanishads do mention Sat, Brahma, Atma, Hiranyagarbham, Shivan, Indran, et al. Also Purushan, Narayanan are also mentioned to denote God. The word Narayana is the only word to denote only one, Sriman Narayana, the Divine One, who has Sri as his divine consort. Hrishchate Lakshmischa Patnyav, says Purusha Suktam. The Purusha Suktam talks about Purusha, Purusha, and finally it says that he is the Purusha who has got Sri as the divine consort. So the Divine One who has Sri as his divine consort. Nara means the beings or bodies of beings. One who possesses these beings, or the one who is the indweller of these beings, is therefore called Narayana. Narayana is the term derived from the Vyutpatis, Narana, Ayanam, and Yasya Naraha Ayanam. Nara means Vishnu, Narayana, because he is imperishable. Nara means the entire universe, composed of Chit and Achit entities, which originated from Nara, as Nara is the cause of the entire universe, having the subtle Chit and Achit as his Sariram, as his body, before creation, and creates them by giving the expanded form in Stula Sariram, having the expanded Chit and Achit as his body. Naranam Ayanam means Narayana is the base and support for all Chit and Achit Tattvams. This shows the Bahirvyapti, the manner in which Narayana pervades the universe. Antar Bahishchatat Sarva Vyapya Narayana Sthitaha. Narayana is the one who manifests inside and outside of everything and everyone. Narayana is present inside all Chit and Achit entities as the ultimate controller, Antaryami, the soul, and owner, the Seshi, the Lord of everything. This shows the Antarvyapti, the manner in which Narayana is present inside everything. The Na Kara in the end of the term Narayana, without doubt, Na, the Munusui Na, says that the term Narayana is a particular noun denoting the Lord of Goddess Lakshmi, who is Vishnu. This is confirmed by the grammatical rule of the Vedas, Vyakaranam, one among the six accessories of Veda, and by Panini's grammatical treatise as well. Thus, the Vedams identify the Supreme Self as Sriman Narayana. It is the application of the Chagapasunyayam. Further, used the Brahma Sutra recognizes only the Pancharatra Agamam as the authoritative, as the Veda, and rejects all other ordered works like Sankhya Yoga, Vaisheshika, Charvaka, Bauddham, Jaina, and Pashupata Shaiva. It further identifies the Supreme Self by Ubayalingam, the two identifications of Sriman Narayana, namely Ananta Kalyana Gunaganoga Maharnavam, Gunakaratvam, the Supreme Self. Sriman Narayana has infinite, auspicious, divine qualities. And Agileheya Pratyanigatvam, Supreme Self, who is completely untouched by any defects and imperfections. These two identifications apply only to Sriman Narayana. and it does not apply to any other deity. Therefore, it is ascertained beyond doubt in Vedas and Shastras from the authority of Veda that Sriman Narayana is the unparalleled and unsurpassed Supreme Self. And Purusha also refers to Sriman Narayana only. As I mentioned, Hrishchate Lakshmischa Patnyau in Purusha Suktam is enough for one to categorically know who is Supreme. There is one Narayana Upanishad in Krishna Yajurveda which elucidates the nature and function of Lord Sriman Narayana. This indicates from various principles and forces from Narayanan, sequentiality is to his desire to create. And when Vedas mention Shiva, Rudra, Indra, Brahma, etc. as God, we substitute those names as the indweller in them, as the antaryami of them, as Sriman Narayana. Then the statement would make sense, because Narayana is the embodiment of the whole universe. He has the unique qualities of being blemishless, faultless, sinless, changeless, purest and divine, devoid of any old age, weakness, hunger, etc. So sage Veda Vyasa, the one who compiled all Vedas, one who wrote 18 Puranas, one who wrote the Mahabharatam, is the one who declared, raising his both hands, Satyam, Satyam, Punas Satyam, Udritya Bhujamuchyate, Vedas Shastra Param Nasti Nadevam Keshavat Param. There is no other Shastras than Vedas, and there is no other God than Keshava. The Purusha who was created by Sriman Narayana is called as Brahma, Chaturmukha Brahma. And Ka is the name of Chaturmukha Brahma. Shiva says, I am the master called Isha. And both Brahma and I, the Ka and Isha, are born of you. And hence you are called Keshava. Ka iti Brahmano nama Ishoham sarva dehinam. Avam tavamge sambhutav tasmat Keshava namavan. The primordial one was Sriman Narayana. From him was born the four-faced Chaturmukha Brahma. And from him was born Shivaha. So, Narayanat Rudro Jayate, Narayanat Indro Jayate, Narayanat Brahmo Jayate. So, all the celestial bodies, including Brahma, Rudra, Indra, et al., and all great sages are solely worshipping the Supreme Lord Sriman Narayana. Sankha Chakra Gadabani Dwaraka Nilayachuta Govinda Pundarikaksha Rakshamam Charanagatam. It is thus declared unambiguously that demigods like Rudra, Brahma, Indra and everyone and everything are creation of Supreme Lord Sriman Narayana. And Sriman Narayana is the indweller antaryami of all. It's pointed out that Jivatmas, due to their great karmas, have attained these positions of Rudra, Brahma, Indra et al. They are only position, they are powers. They are like the general managers and vice presidents and executive vice presidents of a corporation. Whereas Sriman Narayana is the owner of the corporation. By means of their service to the Lord, they have attained these positions. It's time bound, beyond which they need to be born again in different bodies. They hold such positions on account of grace by Sriman Narayana, the one without a second. These demigods are also bound and subordinate to the delusion of matter or prakriti and are dominated by three gunas, sattvam, rajas and tamas. Their jnanam are also subject to expansion and contraction just like each one of us. And they serve the Lord, their indweller, in accordance with their best understanding of the Lord and their abilities. They too are the inseparable attributes of the Lord, just like you and me. All these demigods are dependent on Lord Sriman Narayana for gaining jnanam and power to grant the little fruits to others, their respective devotees, says Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. All of these demigods or celestial bodies cannot be pure because they are also subjected to trigunas. We should know that we should understand that their jnanam is not fully expanded, maybe much more than ours, but definitely not as much as Sriman Narayana, because they are born according to their karma. Sriman Narayana has got no karma attached to him. All living beings up to Chaturmukha Brahma, down to the smallest insect, are beings that are migrating in this world on account of their own karmas. The Supreme Narayana is the ultimate refuge for all of us. These demigods take refuge in Rudra. Rudra has Brahma as his refuge, and Brahma takes refuge in me. I have no one to take refuge. I am the final refuge, says the Lord. Even Rudra says in Mantra Rajapada Stotram, same thing. Dasa Bhutaha Swatas Sarve Atmana Paramatmanaha Atohamapite Dasaha Iti Matva Namamyaham. All Atmans are servants of that Paramatma by their very nature. So also I am your Dasa. Knowing thus, I seek refuge in you, says Rudra. Thus, one who has understood Vedas and Shastras, Upanishad correctly, would never ever consider anyone else other than Sriman Narayana as the Supreme God. If anyone thinks like that, they don't believe in Vedas. They are not Vaidikas. They are not even Astikas. Vedas declare unambiguously Sriman Narayana as the Supreme. Enough said. Adiyen. Alavandar Trivadilai Sharanam. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline. Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Namo Narayana.